Citicore wrapping up work on its wind energy portfolio as it partners with Singapore's Levanta for its maiden portfolio consisting of 4 onshore wind projects located in Luzon and Visayas, all of which secured offtake via the Department of Energy's Green Energy Auction Program in July 2023 and total 375 megawatts. The goal is for the wind portfolio to hit 3 gigawatts of operating generation capacity over the medium term and long term to complement its 5 gigawatts of solar energy in 5 years or until 2028. Now, for more on this, Citicore's Oliver Tan joins us live from the Philippine Stock Exchange in Taguig. Hi, Ollie. Thank you so much for joining us. Good morning.
Hi, good morning. It's nice to be back at your show.
So, Ollie, first of all, what are you doing at the exchange?
Well, I'm part of the panel interview for the Road to IPO event of PSE.
All right. You are one of the big success stories there. So I want to start with, why don't you talk to us about your progression into wind? I know that C-REC started big in solar and now you're getting into wind.
Yes, the idea is to come up with a base load renewable, pure renewable energy portfolio. So the wind projects will complement our solar and together complemented by energy storage system for us to have the ability to provide pure renewable energy to our customer on a longer hours.
Mm-hmm. When you say complement, so it's not the main source of energy. Solar will still be the main source, right? 5 gigawatts by 2028 versus 3 gigawatts for wind. Is that the ideal mix that you're seeing?
Yes, what I meant by complement is on a portfolio basis, we're able to provide not only day power requirement, even night power requirement of our customers.
Mm-hmm. All right. So why don't you talk to us about this partnership with Levanta of Singapore, which is a big Southeast Asia platform for wind. How does the partnership work? Who brings what to the table?
Yeah, so Levanta is a Southeast Asian renewable energy platform backed by Actis. If Actis sounds familiar, you may have heard their most recent investment with Meralco. So Levanta, we view them not only as a financial partner, but more of a strategic partner. They will bring in their technical know-how as they have several operating wind projects already in the region. This will further complement our local knowledge and engineering know-how.
The financial side, is it going to be a 50-50 partnership? How much money are they bringing in?
Yes, for wind projects that own land, they are limited to 40%. Mm-hmm. However, for wind projects, for project level that doesn't own land, it's a 50-50 joint venture.
Mm-hmm. So how much money are we talking about, Ollie? How much money is C-REC, for example, putting out versus Levanta?
I may not be at liberty to disclose that.
Not yet.
But many zeros.
Many zeros. All right. Okay. So this partnership will cover 4 onshore wind projects located in Luzon and Visayas, totaling 375 megawatts, correct?
That's correct.
All right. What's the timeline like?
We recently signed the joint venture agreement. Obviously, there will be customary closing requirement. So we're looking at probably achieving transaction closure before the end of the year.
Mm-hmm. All right. And when do you expect the wind projects to start, you know, sending power to the grid?
The target is to achieve energization by end of 2026.
All right. That's 2 years down the road.
Yes, indeed.
Okay. So I wonder, are you at liberty as well to tell us the locations of the 4 projects?
So one in Visayas, this is in the Iloilo. Mm-hmm. The other 3 are in Luzon.
Mm-hmm. Where in Luzon?
One in South Luzon, in Camarines Sur. The other 2 are in Pangasinan and Bataan.
All right. You know, Oli, there is a notion, and tell us whether this notion is actually correct, that onshore wind is, the wind may not be as strong, but the landscape is easier. Offshore, they say, the wind is very strong, but logistics becomes more challenging and construction becomes more expensive. Is that notion correct? And if so, what made you decide to do onshore first?
That's actually correct. We do have some offshore wind projects, but we decided to first do our onshore wind. Offshore wind, there are two kinds actually. If the offshore winds are located near onshore, where the depth are shallower than the others, it's more challenging from an engineering, design, construction, and logistic point of view.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. All right. But you're also going to pursue offshore after your onshore projects.
Yes, actually we are developing quite a number of offshore projects in parallel as well.
Mm, all right, how many offshore? And what sort of capacity are we looking at?
We were awarded, if I'm not mistaken, 7 offshore wind contracts. We're looking at potential aggregate capacity of around 3 gigawatt as well.
Wow. Oli, these are very big projects. You did say you're spending an amount with lots of zeros. Are we expecting CREC to be going back to the capital markets to raise money or maybe head out to your favorite banks?
All of the above.
All of the above. Wow. All right. Over the next 6 months, for example, is there an amount that you're looking to hit?
We're looking at increasing our public float, obviously, after our lock-up period, which is this coming December 7th. But most likely, we will be returning to the capital market by next year.
Okay. Returning to capital market by next year. No target amount.
We will be disclosing as
all right,
as we have information.
All right. When you look at the wind energy in the RE space in general, there is a criticism that, you know, wind, it's kind of intermittent, and you don't really know when it's going to happen. Is that still a problem today, or do you think we have enough new technologies, AI, you know, data learning to help us predict the wind better?
I think with the advancement and evolution of energy storage system, like battery in particular, this will help address the intermittency brought by wind and solar and smoothen the generation capability of this technology.
Mm-hmm. And will wind energy be cheaper or more expensive than solar and then more expensive than coal?
Wind will be more expensive than solar from a levelized cost of energy, but it should be at par with coal, depending on where coal prices will be.
All right, at current prices?
At current prices, I would say it's at par.
At par with coal. So solar is now really cheaper?
Solar is cheaper, yes.
Then why haven't everyone made the switch yet?
Well, I think more and more corporates and mm-hmm. Entities are looking at the solar space already.
All right. You know, whenever we talk about wind energy, we always remember the story of Don Quixote, Cervantes's classic. You know, wind energy has had powerful foes. What do you think is the biggest challenge for wind RE here in the Philippines?
Well, for wind, it's really the logistic issue and the port facility. Because unlike solar, where they are at the lowland, wind are mostly at the highland. So especially with the access road, bringing the wind turbines up to the highland, it's quite challenging, really. So it's really the road infrastructure.
Mm-hmm. And so what do you need government to do to make wind work, you know, to make the business of wind viable? Do we also need additional incentives to spark this clean energy revolution, to help fuel, you know, to help fuel wind?
Of course, we welcome more incentive, but current incentive, I think, is already fine. What we need is to improve the ease of doing business, securing local permits in particular.
Mm, you know, we've heard that All industries talk about that. How many permits are you required to be able to set up one wind farm? Could you give us an idea? How many permits? How long?
To my last count, I think around 200 signatures from national to local barangay levels, I'm not mistaken.
200, that's a lot of people to go through. All right, talk to us more about ambitions. Anything else that's big on the horizon for your wind plants, your wind ambitions?
Yeah, so I think we're aiming for 3 gigawatts of installed capacity in the medium term. We are rolling out quite a significant amount of solar power, 1 gigawatt per year in the next 5 years. That's already quite a handful. Notwithstanding, we're here to continue to support the energy transition plan of our government through the Department of Energy.
Mm-hmm. Are you also looking at doing projects abroad?
Currently, we're focused in the Philippines because there's really massive investment required in the space right now. Mm-hmm. But obviously, we are entrepreneur. Should there be compelling investment thesis to look outside of the Philippines, we will always be keep an open mind about it.
Mm-hmm. And of course, you did mention that you are there as a panelist for the road to IPO of the PSE. We remember that you guys were one of the few companies that braved market volatility. You raised $5.3 billion from your IPO this year. Why do you think companies should go to the capital markets if they want to scale?
Well, I think market condition has improved quite a lot compared to earlier this year where we did the IPO. As long as companies have sound business plan, business model, and has the track record to execute, IPO, in our opinion, will provide you the necessary financial strength to achieve your goals.
All right, the financial strength and the muscle to achieve the great, great ambitions. 5 gigawatts solar, 3 gigawatts of wind. What about hydro?
We're currently building one run-of-river hydro. Hydro for us is more difficult to build. That's why we wanted to perfect first our first run-of-river and then see how we can scale up from there.
All right. You know, Oli, for those who are watching, they better believe your story because the stock price, your stock price, actually proves it. Your stock price is north of 3 pesos 30 centavos a piece. I remember IPO was below 3, right? 2.7?
Yes, that's correct.
2.7. All right. Clearly, your shareholders and investors do believe in the story. Thank you very much, Oli, for joining us. Congratulations on the new partnership. We look forward to more exciting news from CREC.
Thank you, and it's my pleasure.
All right.